In previous video, we discussed the temperature distribution between two parallel plates, named as plane Poiseuille flow, plane Corti flow, generalized Corti flow, and flow between a pipe with different temperature and same temperature, and flow between two concentric rotating cylinder. Now, in this video, we discuss the temperature distribution of plane Corti flow with transpiration cooling. This result is applicable in refrigeration. So this is the most important result in the fluid dynamics. Suppose this is the diagram of figure 1. This shows the velocity distribution in velocity in this problem. Consider the steady flow of a viscous incompressible fluid between two parallel plates placed at a distance h apart along x-axis. The y-axis is taken normal to the plate. The lower plate is at rest and same fluid is injected at the rate V0 through it, and the upper plate is moving with velocity capital U in its own plane either or along x-axis. And same fluid is withdrawn suction at the same rate V0 through it. Since the plate are infinite, then non-zero component of velocity is small u and will be the function of y only. So the velocity distribution in the dimensionless form is given by small u upon capital U is equal to e ki power lambda into n minus 1 upon e ki power lambda minus 1, where n is equal to y by h, and lambda is known as injection parameter, in which in injection parameter lambda is equal to V0 into h upon nu, where nu is the kinematic viscosity. Let the temperature of the plate be 2 and upper plate be T1, and T0 and T1 are constant. So the governing equation of energy for steady flow of a viscous incompressible fluid in the absence of external heat is given by rho into Cp into V0 d by dy of capital T is equal to kappa into d square capital T upon dy square plus mu into d by dy square, where Cp is the specific heat at constant pressure and rho is the density, V0 is injection velocity, T is the temperature, where and kappa is thermal conductivity. This is our equation number 2. Now the boundary conditions. The boundary condition are when y distance y is equal to 0, temperature is T0, and distance y is equal to h, then temperature T1. This is our equation number 3. Introducing the non-dimensionless parameter, n is equal to y by h, lambda is equal to V0 into h upon u, this is injection parameter, and T minus T0 upon T1 minus T0, we write as is T star, which is non-dimensional parameter of temperature. EC is equal to U capital U square upon Cp into T1 minus T0, and we know very well that this is the Eckart number. And Pr is equal to mu into Cp upon kappa, this is known as Prandtl number. And when the Peclet number Pe dash is equal to lambda into Pr, lambda is injection parameter and Pr is Prandtl number. So the equation 2 with the help of the equation 1 can be written as d square t star upon dn square minus p dash dt star upon dn is equal to minus ec into p dash into e ki power 2 lambda upon e ki power lambda minus 1 ka whole square, where star denote the non-dimensional parameter of temperature, and the corresponding boundary conditions become when n is equal to 0, theta is equal to 0, when n is equal to 1, theta is equal to 1. This is our equation number 5. So the solution of the equation 4 subject to the boundary condition 5 is T star. T star means non-dimensional parameter of temperature is equal to EC into Peclet number upon e ki power lambda minus 1 ka whole square into e ki power Peclet number into 1 minus e ki power 2 lambda minus Peclet number into n upon 2 lambda minus Peclet number minus e ki power Peclet number into 1 minus e ki power 2 lambda minus Peclet number upon 2 lambda minus Peclet number into e ki power n into Peclet number minus 1 upon e ki power Peclet number minus 1 plus e ki power n into Peclet number minus 1 upon e की power Peclet minus 1. This is the our equation number 6. If the generated due to a internal friction is neglected, either or if the EC is taken to be 0, then this equation 6 become T star is equal to e की power n into Peclet number minus 1 upon e की power Peclet number minus 1, where T star denotes that non-dimensional temperature. This is our equation number 7. In order to see the heat transfer at the stationary plate, let us calculate the dimensionless coefficient of heat transfer, which is known as Nusselt number. And in present notation, Nusselt number nu is equal to delta upon delta n of T star at n is equal to 0. This is the equation number 8. Put value of T star from 7 in 8, and after simplification, we get Nusselt number is equal to Peclet number upon e key power Peclet number minus 1. This is our equation number 9. So, when lambda is equal to 0, it means Peclet number is 0. So, the value of the Nusselt number, is unity, and it goes on decreasing as the value of Peclet number increases, which show the cooling of stationary plate with the injection process. Thank you.